Hi guys, it's Robert McGowan here from Practically Free Porsche, and today I'd like to talk a little bit about car depreciation and when I think it's the best time to buy a used Porsche. Car purchase is the second biggest purchase after a house for most people, and it can be very expensive, and the biggest cost in a vehicle purchase is usually down to the depreciation. And in the UK at least, a car can depreciate up to about two-thirds or more sometimes, and depending on the type of car in the UK, and that, you know, over 3 years, and that can sometimes be £12,000-£13,000, which is roughly the price of a nice Boxer 987, and I know what I would rather have. So if you're looking to buy a newish 911, for example, probably the best time to buy that, I would say, is probably within maybe 2 or 3 years of it being new. Porsches tend to buck the trend a little bit with depreciation, and a new 911 will probably depreciate about 17% in the first year, then maybe 12% in the second year, then possibly 10% in the third year, before slowly tapering off to a point where it levels off after 10, 12 years. So again, you know, if you're looking for the sweet spot of quite newness and low miles and that type of thing, then possibly 2-3 years old is likely the sweet spot for most Porsches, or probably most cars for that matter. I don't think that's where the most value lies personally. For me, I would say that the you get more value from the older cars. I mean, a 10, 12-year-old car, or even older, with all or most of the depreciation taken out, it's going to give you most of the enjoyment and the value of a new Porsche at a fraction of the price. So it kind of makes sense to think about, you know, heading for an older car. Now, with regards to miles, you know, you should never be put off by high miles. As long as the car has a full service history and in good condition, Porsches can take high miles more than most. So as long as the price reflects this, then high miles shouldn't be a problem. Same with the number of owners on the logbook shouldn't really faze you too much. Quite often, Porsche sports car, most sports cars can have a private registration plate put on them at some point in time, and that's going to show up as a new owner, even though it isn't. So again, new owners or a high number of owners shouldn't ring too many alarm bells. Now, even if a car is very well optioned and spec'd, it doesn't seem to have too much of an implication with regards to the level at which it depreciates. So go for a kind of a higher spec car, especially if you're looking for a slightly newer one. The older cars, including the transaxle types of 924, 944, 968, 928, and all the early 911s and the Boxers and Caymans, all the way up to, you know, the kind of 2010, maybe, just after that, these cars are mostly depreciated and levelled out, and in some cases they tend to kind of pick back up again. And in fact, in some cases, brand new Porsches can actually buck the trend completely because, you know, an Arret, for example, or a special edition, maybe a GT3 RS, or a Sport Classic or something, these cars are often get waiting lists to go, you know, to buy them. So anything that's low volume and, you know, exotic like that and kind of, you know, pretty special, all Porsches are special, but, you know, these special editions, these tend to be sometimes worth more than the purchase price when you buy them. So that's something to think about as well. But if I would say the sweet spot, 2 or 3 years old for most cars. But if you want to go even better value, then go older and just buy the right car in the right condition with the right history, and you should be fine. Now, another thing that people are asking me right now is, you know, should I buy a new car just now or should I hold off? Well, it's difficult to tell for sure. I mean, without dusting off my crystal ball, you can't really accurately judge, you know, what's going to happen in the market in the future. But some people are talking about the possibility of a correction in the near future, with the possibility of a recession. And, you know, some people are predicting a recession. Hard to say whether that's going to happen or not, you know, but if it does, it could have a reflection on the used car prices. You know, I remember back in August 2007, I bought my first Porsche, and it was just before the financial crash of 2008. And at that time, I paid £11,000 for my 3.2 Targa Sport. Now, throughout the financial crisis, that car didn't really change much in value, whereas newer cars that were maybe worth £30,000, £40,000, £50,000 upwards, those cars and quite, you know, more expensive classics did definitely take a bit of a financial hit. So, you know, if we use the same sort of pattern going forward, then I would say if you're looking to spend maybe 5, 10, 15, even 20 grand on a used Porsche, I don't think, you know, you'd probably be advised just, you know, to do that. If it does take a hit, I don't think it would be too much of a hit. And even if it is, if you're holding on to the car, then it really shouldn't matter. Because typically in 2 or 3 years' time after a correction, the cars can slowly climb back up again. So don't be put off, you know, your money in your bank's going to come and go, but as your time only goes, so why wait? Just buy the Porsche that you want to buy and enjoy it and just use it every chance you get. You stand a good chance, if you hold on to it long enough, of getting most of your money back anyway. You know, so that, you know, so there's no real loss there. So, you know, and even if you wanted to sell your car in a crisis moment or whatever, to upgrade to a different type, then really, you know, the price is going to be negligible, because the car that you're buying, even though it's more expensive, that will come down, and that will be down in price as well, just like your car has. So you're not really losing. The only way I can see you would lose is if you were to downgrade and maybe take a slight hit on your car, you know, and buy a cheaper car. But even then, I mean, these things are all, the most important thing here is not really the money. It's about enjoying your life, enjoying the Porsche of your dreams. So my advice to you guys is, you know, don't delay. Just go out and buy your Porsche. Do your homework on the particular model and make sure you buy a good one, and you'll be happy days. So guys, I hope that's given you some kind of a insight as to what to look for. Hope you enjoyed it. If you have, give us a wee thumbs up and subscribe. And if you want to see more Porsche-related content, then put it in the comments below, and I'll do my best to do it in the weeks and months ahead. Thanks for watching, guys. Until next time, cheerio.